Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss the applications of Gauss law. That means how Gauss law can be used to find out the formula of E bar or D bar due to a point charge. How we can use Gauss law to find out E bar and D bar for infinite line charge. In this lecture we also going to cover how we can use Gauss law to find out D bar or E bar due to infinite sheet of charge. Although we have found out the E bar relationship for all of these cases with the help of Coulomb's law, in this particular lecture we will try to answer how the Gauss law can be used to derive the same formula which we already used in the numericals as well as in the previous lectures. So before going through this, let me explain again what exactly Gauss law. We actually covered it in the previous lecture, so let us take a review on Gauss law. So what exactly Gauss law is? Gauss law is very simple. It states that the electric flux passing through any closed surface, electric flux psi passing through any closed surface, is exactly equal to charge enclosed by that closed surface. So how much flux will come out of a closed surface? The amount of charge enclosed into that surface. If the charge enclosed in a closed surface or volume is 10 coulomb, then 10 coulomb flux will come out of that closed surface. If the charge enclosed in a cubic volume is minus 10 coulomb or minus 100 coulomb, then minus 100 coulomb flux will come out of that cubical closed surface. This is very simple. And we also found that psi is also equal to integration of d bar dot ds bar, and q is equal to integration rho v dv. These two equations we already know, we covered it in previous lectures. And then using these two relations, psi is equal to q as well as psi is equal to integration d bar dot ds bar, therefore we get this part, okay. And q is also equal to rho v dv, so that's why we get this part using this relationship. Okay, now by applying divergence theorem on this middle part, we can convert the surface integral into volume integral. For that only we have to do what? Take the divergence of d bar. So according to divergence theorem, surface integral of any vector is exactly equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. Now comparing these two equations, okay, comparing this right hand side and this right hand side, we find volume integral is there and here is also volume integral. So del dot d bar must be equal to rho v. So del dot d bar. Sometimes you can use D, sometimes in the slide I use D bar, so one and the same thing. So in the previous lecture I told you that psi is equal to Q is equal to this D bar dot DS bar. This particular part is called as integral form of Gauss law because it involves integration. So it is called as, this equation is called as integral form of Gauss law, okay. And this particular equation is called as point form of Gauss law, point, because derivative, del operator consists of derivative formula, hence it is a point form of Gauss law. Volume charge density is equal to divergence of d bar. This is nothing but Gauss law. Now how we can use the Gauss law in order to find out d bar due to a point charge? For example, your point charge is located at origin like this. This is your point charge Q, okay, and you want to find out D bar at point P, somewhere here. Point P is somewhere here. So the coordinates of this point P would be R. What will the coordinates? R theta and some phi might be there. So coordinates are not required. Suppose the point charge Q is located at origin, okay, this is okay. To determine D bar at point P, it is easy to see that choosing A spherical surface containing P will satisfy our symmetry condition. So what is this exactly? Whenever you want to apply Gauss law, you require what? Closed surface. You require this closed surface. Closed surface is of any shape. Okay. And in the honor of this scientist, this closed surface, whatever closed surface you select, is also called as Gaussian surface. Now, whenever the requirement is that whenever you want to apply a Gauss law to any situation, you have to select a closed surface, means Gaussian surface. In this particular problem, the Gaussian surface selected is a sphere. The sphere of radius r such that the point P appears on the outer surface of the sphere. Okay? So, why the sphere is selected here? Because we want symmetry. The spherical means the closed surface size and shape of closed surface must be symmetrical about the charge. The shape of the closed surface selected must be symmetrical about the given charge. This is the condition of Gauss law. So if here is a point charge Q and point P, you want to find out D bar or E bar at point P, then what kind of symmetrical closed surface you can take? Obviously sphere if you take, then it is symmetrical around this charge Q. Okay. Now since D bar is everywhere normal to the Gaussian surface, that is let us consider D bar present at point P due to this charge Q. Obviously due to this charge Q, some force is there on this point, some E bar is also there at this point, and some D bar is also there at this point. All direction of all these parameters will be same, means outward, going outward from Q in this direction. So this is the direction of E bar, F bar as well as D bar. So let us assume that the D bar present at this point is D is equal to dr ar cap. Why dr ar cap? Because as the surface you consider is a sphere, that means you have to follow spherical coordinate system, third coordinate system. Spherical coordinate system. You can recall back, in spherical coordinate system the coordinates are second coordinate is theta and third coordinate in spherical coordinate system is phi. Okay, so three unit vectors are ar cap, a theta cap and a phi cap. Okay, what is the direction of ar cap? Direction of ar cap is nothing but a radial direction, because the first plane in spherical system is spherical plane, sphere. R plane is nothing but a sphere, okay, in spherical system. So ar cap direction is always from origin to radially outward. So this is the direction of ar cap, this is the direction of ar cap, this is the direction of ar cap, and this would also be direction of ar cap. Okay. So let us assume that d bar is present only in radial direction, d bar is present only in r direction, d bar is absent in theta and phi direction. So if we assume this, then d bar will be very simple. D bar is equal to dr ar cap. Okay, d bar ar cap. That means no a theta component, no a phi component. This is the assumption. Okay. Now we are having, according to Gauss law, Q is equal to d bar dot ds bar. Okay, by putting this dr ar cap here, okay, dr ar cap here, you will get dr, because what is ds? What is ds in this case? In case of spherical system, ds r bar, ds theta bar and ds phi bar. Let me show you the slide. In spherical system, yes, this is the slide. Yes. In spherical system, ds r bar is there, ds theta bar is there, ds phi bar is there. Okay, in our formula, which whether to take ds r bar or ds theta bar or ds phi bar, that we have to decide. But looking at the figure here, we can very easily understand that the ds, which ds we have to consider, the ds we have to consider is nothing but that ds which is perpendicular to this ar cap. Okay, so d bar dot ds bar, what is the direction of d bar? Or say you can apply another logic, very simple logic. If the direction of d bar is ar cap, so this ds must be ds r bar, this must ds must be ds r bar. So ds r bar is what? How will you find out ds r bar? Can you recall back? Ds r bar is equal to multiply remaining two differential lengths, which are the two differential lengths, r d theta, r sin theta d phi. Okay, so dr ar cap, if you put this dr ar cap here in place of this, and ds bar you can put r d theta, yes, r d theta, r sin theta d phi, ar cap. So ar cap dot ar cap will be 1, and you will get this. Or I think they have not substituted this ds as a differential length, it is kept as it is. For example, so what they have done, let me explain again. What they have done, in this particular equation they have put d bar. What is the d bar? Dr ar cap, bracket complete, and dot product is there, dot, what is ds? Ds is also in which area, in which direction? Ar cap, because where is your point P? Point P is somewhere here, so this is your ds. So what is the direction of this ds? The direction of this ds is nothing but the direction which is perpendicular to this surface. Okay, so perpendicular direction is which? Ar cap or a theta cap or a phi cap? Ar cap. What is the direction of a theta cap? A theta cap is the direction, you can you recall back the right circular cone? It comes from z axis towards negative z axis. Okay, so let us assume that ds is ds, and direction of this is, because this is d bar and this is ds bar, so magnitude and direction, magnitude and direction, ar cap. So what is this? Q is equal to d bar dot ds bar is equal to integration of dr ar cap dot product with, yes, this is ds, ds ar cap. So this is magnitude, this is also magnitude, ar cap dot ar cap is 1, dot product of same unit vectors is 1. So what is left? Only dr is left and ds is left. So dr is taken outside this integration side and ds is somewhere here. Now what is the surface area? Integration of ds, integration of ds is total surface area. So what is the total surface area of sphere in this case? 4 pi r square. Okay, 4 pi r square. Integration of surface area is 4 pi r square, or the same logic which we discussed, ds in this case is ds r bar. Ds r bar is nothing but r square sin theta d phi. How will you obtain ds r bar? Multiply remaining two differential lengths, so r square sin theta d phi will be there, and integrating it, theta varies from 0 to pi and phi varies from 0 to 2 pi, you will get 4 pi r square. This way also you can get 4 pi r square. Now shifting this 4 pi r square on this side, on the denominator, so dr, can you calculate dr in this equation? Dr is equal to, move this 4 pi r square on this side, dr will be equal to q upon 4 pi r square. Once you get this dr, put this value in this formula. Okay, so you will get d bar is equal to q upon 4 pi r square ar cap. So this is the formula of d bar due to a point charge. The same formula we also obtained using Coulomb's law. From this formula you can also obtain E bar. How? Because you know the formula of D bar, relationship between D bar and E bar is epsilon 0 into E bar. Okay, so how will you get E bar from this D bar? Divide the D bar by epsilon 0, divide the D bar by epsilon 0, you will get E bar. So E bar will be equal to Q upon 4 pi epsilon 0 r square ar cap, which is the same which we obtained in the Coulomb's law case. Infinite surface charge, infinite line charge. How would you obtain the D bar due to infinite line charge? Using Gauss law. Let us assume that infinite line charge is kept on z axis, okay, and you want to find out D bar at any point. Suppose this is infinite line charge which is kept on z axis. This is infinite line charge. This is assumption, okay, and we want to find out the D bar or E bar at any point somewhere here. This is point P. This is point P. So you have to take, if you want to use Gauss law, you have to consider a closed surface such that it must be symmetric as well as it must cover this given point P. Such a symmetrical surface in this case could only be a cylinder, such that cylinder is symmetrical about the given charge distribution. It is symmetrical about this line as well as it covers the point P. So in this case, for infinite line charge case, if you want to apply Gauss law, you have to consider what kind of Gaussian surface or closed surface? A cylinder like this, okay. So in this case, again we will use this particular formula. Q is equal to integration d bar dot ds bar. So this integration can be split for three kinds of surfaces. For this cylinder, there is a top surface, there is a bottom surface, this is a bottom surface, and this is a lateral surface. So you can split this integration in this fashion. It is equal to d bar dot ds bar is equal to integration for top side d bar dot ds bar plus for lateral surface, of this cylinder, and integration for bottom surface. I cannot write here, just try to understand. So integration d bar dot ds bar, integration is equal to this d bar dot ds bar can be split in this fashion. For top surface, because what kind of ds you need to consider here using in this figure? Obviously this closed surface you consider is cylinder. So for cylinder there is top surface, there is bottom surface, there is lateral surface, okay. So that's why this integration can be split into three parts. For top surface it is different, for bottom surface, and one lateral surface. So which part you need to consider here? As looking at this diagram, due to this charge, line charge, what is the direction of force at this point? Obviously due to this charge, the force must be in this direction. This force must be in this direction. That means E bar, D bar, F bar must be in this direction. Which direction? This direction. That means due to this charge, the force will be along P bar from this point. So which is this surface? This is a lateral surface, because D bar is coming out from lateral surface of cylinder. There is no D bar coming out from top surface. There is no D bar coming out from bottom surface. So D bar is present only on lateral surface. So which is the direction of this lateral surface? Obviously AR cap, okay, because this is a radius, this is radius of cylinder. That means this is AR cap, this is also AR cap. So AR cap is a direction in which the radius of cylinder increases. Suppose this is a z axis, this is cylinder. So radius increases in which direction? In AR cap direction, because radius increases, radius equally increases, radius of cylinder equally increases from z axis, therefore this is AR cap. So d bar is present only in AR direction. So let us assume d bar is dr AR cap. Remember, as in cylindrical system, some people write here d rho a rho, but many times we will follow dr AR cap. So by putting this dr AR cap here, and ds is ds AR cap, so by taking the dot product you will get dr ds, integration ds, and integration of ds is nothing but here in the previous derivation integration of ds was for sphere, because sphere was the closed surface in the previous derivation. In this case, this ds means the total surface area of cylinder. So what is the total surface area of cylinder? You can find 2 pi r into l. Suppose the l is the length of cylinder, so 2 pi r is the circumference, will be the circumference for this top surface, and l is the length. So total surface area of any cylinder is always equal to 2 pi r l. Okay, so here we also know that q is also equal to once you reach this particular equation here, now you also know that q is equal to rho l dl, or q is equal to rho l into l. Now comparing this left hand side and this right hand side, you can find that l is there. Here also you cancel this l and simplify this particular equation for dr. Okay, for dr if you simplify, then it will become 2 pi epsilon will be moved on this side. Okay, so rho l upon 2 pi r into ar cap would be your dr, and d bar would be rho l upon 2 pi r ar cap. So this way you can find out the infinite line charge d bar or e bar due to infinite line charge using Gauss law. Using Gauss law means you have to remember this. Okay, d bar is not present for top surface, bottom surface, it is only present for lateral surface. That's why integration of ds bar, ds which ds? Lateral surface. Infinite sheet of charge, similarly, by using Gauss law for infinite sheet of charge, that means infinite surface charge, it is found that the formula will be rho s upon 2 epsilon 0 az cap. And one problem is there on Gauss law. We will try to solve this problem. So d bar given is, d bar vector given is z rho, rho means r, cos square phi az cap coulomb per meter square. Calculate the charge density at, calculate the charge density means rho v at 1 comma pi by 4 comma 3, and the total charge enclosed by the cylinder of radius 1 meter with minus 2. The dimensions of cylinder is given. What is the dimension of cylinder? Cylinder radius is 1 meter, because cylinder is like this. Cylinder radius is 1 meter, and dimensions are where the cylinder is kept. It is kept along z axis like this. This is z axis. So the cylinder bottom is where, suppose this is z axis, then bottom is placed at minus 2 and top surface is placed at plus 2. Okay, so this is the dimension of cylinder. Given that d bar is given, calculate the charge density means rho v at 1 comma pi by 4 comma 3, and the total charge, that means what is to be found out, rho v and total charge means q, and d bar is given. So what is the formula? There are two formula in Gauss law, if you can recall back. Q is equal to psi is equal to integration of d bar dot ds bar. So what we want to find out in the given problem, I want q. Q is equal to psi. So psi is equal to integration of d bar dot ds bar. So you have to use which formula? This formula you want to use. And another thing, another parameter is also asked to compute volume charge density. Charge density they ask you to find out. So this formula you have to use. Divergence of d bar is equal to rho v. Okay, so in this problem, how would you find out volume charge density? They are asked to find out charge density, means volume charge density in case of Gauss law. So first of all, you need to understand, you need to find out which coordinate system is associated with this problem. In this problem, d bar is given, z is given, r is given, phi is given. It simply means that it is a cylindrical coordinate system. It is not spherical, it is not Cartesian, because phi is mentioned. And it is apparent from this particular coordinates as well. R is given and z is given, and this is the angle. So two lengths are given and one angle is given. So that's why this problem is of cylindrical coordinate system. This you always you need to find out. Any problem, once if somebody asks you any problem to solve, carefully observe which coordinate system is given in the given problem. In this problem, cylindrical system is mentioned. And we are having this particular formula. So you already know how to find out divergence of any vector. We have three formula for divergence of calculation of divergence of any vector. One formula for cylindrical system, one formula for spherical system, and one formula for Cartesian system. As this problem is given in cylindrical system, we have to use cylindrical formula. And we already solved how to calculate the divergence of a given vector. You please refer the previous video, how to calculate the divergence of given vector. Okay, so here by using divergence formula, del by dz az cap. Why? Because d bar is only present in az cap direction. You can note here, d bar is not present in ar cap or fi cap direction. That's why the divergence formula is limited here only to this. So if you want to check the divergence formula for cylindrical system, let me go back to the concerned slide. What is the formula of divergence of any vector? Yes, here is that formula. Yes. For cylindrical coordinate system, the divergence formula is del dot a bar, any vector. In our problem, the vector is now d bar. Del dot a bar is 1 upon r, like this. So this is the component of given vector in r direction, component of given vector in phi direction, component of given vector, any vector, in z direction. In our problem, the d bar is given to be our vector, and d bar is only present in, yes, which direction? Az cap direction in given problem. Some magnitude is given and it is completely absent in ar cap direction and fi cap direction. So that's why there is no need to consider this portion and this portion in our problem, for our problem. So that's why the formula is only limited to del dz. Here you have to take dz and del by del z. That means you have to take the derivative with respect to z only to get del dot d bar. So remember, only this portion is applicable in this problem. Only z component is present for d bar. So that's why the formula used in this solution is, which formula is used in this solution? Del dz by del z. So take the derivative of d bar. D bar is given this. Take the derivative of d bar with respect to z. After taking derivative of this magnitude, you will get rho cos square phi, or it is also called as r cos square phi. Now what is asked to find out? You are asked to find out charge density. You got this volume charge density in terms of some expression. It is not the value, because it is specifically mentioned that find out the charge density at 1, pi by 4, 3. That means r is 1, phi is equal to pi by 4 and z is equal to 3. So put these values r, phi, z, coordinate value of given point in this expression. After putting this, you will get this value, 0.5 coulomb per meter square. This is the answer of the first part, the total charge enclosed by the cylinder. Now next part is find out the total charge enclosed by the cylinder. That means you want to find out Q. So there are two techniques. How would you find out Q? The first technique is you use this formula. Q is equal to rho v into dv, integration rho v dv. Using this formula you can find out. Second formula is using Gauss law. Okay. As there is a cylinder, the Gaussian surface or closed surface mentioned in this problem is cylinder. In the second problem, second method, Q can be found out in this fashion. Q is equal to psi according to Gauss law is equal to d bar dot ds bar is equal to split this integration here. Split this integration into three parts for side surface, for top surface and for bottom surface, because cylinder will have three surfaces. Lateral surface means side surface, top surface and bottom surface. So if you want to use the Gauss law, then you have to split this integration into three parts. Okay, and d bar dot ds bar, it is as it is. So in this way you can use Gauss law here. Okay, and then putting the values in this, you can calculate the psi t. But obviously this method is little bit complicated, although I will solve this problem on board later on, because in PowerPoint I cannot write everything. For explanation, I can clear this particular part, I can cover such problems on board later on. Only you need to understand how to solve these problems. You just understand the methods. So this was the second method of calculating the total charge. The first method is bit simpler. It is equal to Q is equal to rho v into dv, and rho v, you know this expression you already obtained. And what is dv in case of cylindrical coordinate system? Dv is multiplication of three differential lengths. What are the three differential lengths in cylindrical coordinate system? Dr, r d theta, r sine theta, dr, r d phi and dz. So you put this here, put the rho v expression you obtained here, and then do multiplication. And there are how many variables? D phi is there, dr is there, dz is there. You split this, separate these variables according to the variables, and at the end you will get this. Okay, so we will solve this problem on board as well later on. So today we will stop here. Thank you.